web application development, and finally covering, I'll be covering device APIs. This is the Tizen architecture, where, as it already mentioned, that Tizen is a Linux-based operating system. We have Smack-based Linux kernel, that is 4.0 version. On top of that, we have open source component for different types of modules like multimedia messaging. These are open source components. On top of core, we have web framework and native framework. I will be discussing more on web framework. Today, most of the application developers' challenge is porting. So they are adopting HTML5 technology for development so that they can easily port their applications to multiple operating systems. So Tizen has a very good web application development framework which allows you to develop your application smoothly, and it is fully compliant to W3 standards and HTML5 features. Apart from having these standards, it also provides device APIs to use resource-related functionalities like battery or sensors or cameras, whatever it might be. And on top of that, it has web UI framework so that it provides widget support for your web application development. And web runtime is a module which will take care of this web application deploying, installing, and handling the lifecycle of an application. This is the web runtime module, where we already mentioned that if you want to install any web application project onto the device, web runtime is the module which will take care of these things. And WRT installer is the module which will take care of installing the web application onto the device. And WRT client is nothing but which will manages the lifecycle of your web application, like starting the application, if there is any problem, it will pauses and resumes the resources. All these features are being handled by this web runtime client. And coming to the thing is security. Web application has been secured using SMAC technology. We will discuss more about security in our coming slides. Okay. A launchpad is the daemon which will take care of launching application from menu, application menu. This is how the installation and updation happens for even web application. First, for web application will consist of HTML files, JavaScript files, and CSS files. And there is one important file is called config file, which will tell what is the start of your application page. For example, you might be having multiple application. So how will the launcher knows which is the starting of your application? Those things are being defined in this config.xml file. Okay. This W runtime installer will first checks the config file and it will determine whether it is an installation file or an update file. Based on that, different workflow will go through. After that, it will check the certification validation. After meeting the certification validation, it will check whether the files are encrypted or not. After that, it will decrypt the application. So it provides security in terms of encrypting the HTML, JavaScript, and CSS files also. Okay, once these files are decrypted, then it will check the what are the privileges this application is going to have. After checking those things, it will finally install or update your application onto the device. This is the workflow for installation and updation. Okay. And every application will have two processes. One is UI process and another one is web process. UI process, as already mentioned, it will take care of the life cycle of an application. Web process, which is renders your HTML content on the web view. It is basically developed on top of WebKit 2, which is nothing but EFL library based WebKit, port based WebKit. All this process will communicate using IPC mechanism. and security module. No web application will run under root privilege. All the applications will run by this WRT installer, and each application has been sandboxed, so it doesn't have any privileges to interrupt other applications. These privileges, I already defined that in config file there are predefined privileges. By reading these privileges, web installer takes care so that it doesn't read any other data apart from what is defined in config file. In that way, it helps to provide security by using resources, device resources. Okay. We will be talking about details about how to use Tizen SDK for web application. It is nothing but an Eclipse IDE with Tizen plugins and web project explorer, where you can see all the projects in your workspace, edit area where you can edit your HTML, CSS and JavaScript files. Once you does any changes for HTML or CSS files, immediately you can view the preview of your changes. Okay, and then outline and event injector. Outline module will show all the available methods in the active window, and event injector we will talk in detail in coming slides. And console, where we can see the debug messages. And Connection Explorer is the module where we can see the connected devices to your operating system. For example, you can run an emulator, or you can connect your real device to your operating system. All those details will be seen in Connection Explorer, and you can directly deploy your applications on your targeted device using this Connection Explorer. And web simulator. Tizen supports two types of modules. One is web simulator and web emulator for debugging your applications. Web simulator is nothing but a Chrome-based window with device emulated. Here you can debug your applications, and you have to make sure that your application works properly. You can use this web simulator. The only difference between web simulator and web emulator is that web simulator, you can test only one application at a time, and you cannot run two applications and check what is happening. So if you want to test your application in less time, developers will prefer this web simulator, and it has inbuilt support for event injector, inspector, where you can debug all the HTML and JavaScript files. Okay, and one apart from this simulation of device, it provides another module called configuration panel, where you can inject dummy events as a real device has, so that you can test the functionality with prior testing on it to device, actual device. I already mentioned that Connection Explorer will list all the available devices connected to your operating system. There you can see this, it lists the emulator which has been connected, and it will show the file system of that emulator. From this window, you can push or pull files or music files, videos, audios, anything you can pull and push directly onto this emulator. And artificial injector is, as I already mentioned, that to test real functionality of devices without, you can do it using this event injector. For example, if you want to test location services, you cannot do it on your emulator. So you want something injected onto an emulator. Using this location tab, you can inject whatever the latrons you want to test, and it will be injected to your emulator. Once your program runs, it will display the latrons which you have injected into the emulator. So by this dummy events, you can test your location-based services. Not only location, it has support for telephony, SMS, MMS, false, all these things you can test using this event injector. UI builder, instead of writing code, you can just drag and drop and customize your web pages using this UI builder. It will generate the HTML content and CSS content for all the for the design phase. And Tizen has inbuilt support for four types of projects. One is empty project, means it doesn't contain any details, only the config file and the basic HTML files. And a single page project contains details for creating one page application, and multi-page application, it will allows you to create multiple pages, and navigation is the one. It's also like kind of a multi-page, but user can, there is a support how to navigate from one page to another. Apart from this, it has support for offline documentation also. It not only gives details about API usage, but you will know, you can find more information about Tizen tools, and even how, what are the steps you need to follow to upload your application to Tizen store. All those details have been documented in this offline document. And sample applications. To reduce the learning curve, Tizen has 15 more applications which demonstrates the usage of W3 standard base as well as HTML5, and it has support for game development and even painting, all the canvas painting, all such applications are available with the SDK. And user template. As already mentioned, Tizen has provides four types of templates. One is single page, multiple page. If you want to develop your own template, there is a few steps has to be followed so that you can create your own template for to choose for application development. And UI customizer. Tizen framework provides few set of widgets. If you doesn't want to use similar look and feel for that widget, there is a possibility to customize it using UI customizer. You can select the widget, what widget you want to customize, then after making those changes to that particular, this is date picker widget. So Tizen look and feel will be with blue background, and if you can change to rounded corners, and you can change the background color and the text color. After making those changes, what you need to do is you need to export this into a CSS file, and then the changed CSS file has to be imported in your current project. Then you can see the changes whatever you have done using UI customizer. How to create a sample application. This is where it provides basic web, Tizen Web UI framework and jQuery Mobile. Basic, once you select this basic option, it will generate sample, simple HTML, JavaScript and CSS file. There will be no preloaded third party JavaScript libraries. If you select Tizen UI framework, it will preload your web application project with Tizen specific framework libraries. If you select jQuery Mobile, if you want to develop a jQuery Mobile based web application, then you have to choose this jQuery Mobile option. Then it will preload all the jQuery JavaScript and CSS files into your web project. These are the files which will be generated if you select simple project, and this is, these are the files which will be generated if you select UI builder based template. And one more important, has already been seen, the installation and updation happens based on the config file. So this config file has lot of things which user can customize. Here if we see, these are all the features this config file contains. One is overview tab menu, where you can specify your author details and what are the functionality you are providing in this application.
And widget details means if you are restricting your application to one specific resolution like width and height, those options you can choose in this widget. Okay. And features, for example, if your application needs any resource, hardware resources or software resources, you can mention it. These things are used in Tizen store for filtering your application based on resources. And one more thing is privileges. Privileges, as I already mentioned, web applications has been sandboxed. It doesn't allow to use all the system related resources. You have to define it prior using it. If you won't define, for example, if you want to launch your application, want to launch another application. So if you want to define this application dot launch privilege, if even though you are making use of those APIs, it is not going to work. You need to specifically mention what are the privileges your application is going to use. Then only it will work. And policy. For example, your web application want to access some external URL, it directly doesn't do it. You need to mention that what are the sites you are going to visit and what are the subdomains you are going to visit for that site. Those particular details you have to mention it. Then only it will work. The URLs not specified in this policy doesn't work. You have to mention it in this policy, then only your application will able to connect to correct corresponding server. And then preferences. For example, your application wants some predefined values. Like for example, if it is a first time launch, I need to perform few steps. If it is a second time launch, I need to skip those things. Those things you, instead of having an external database, you can store those things using these preferences using key value pairs. Okay? And then source. What all the things we have defined so far will be represented in an XML file. Either you can specify those features using these tabs or you can directly manipulate the XML file. Okay? This is to test your applications on different resolutions. You can create emulator of your own type. Even to it allows to customize emulator of your own choice, but you need to provide the skill and platform for that. This is where you have to launch your application onto the emulator. You can use this run as option where you can see two different types of options, whether it is a web application or web simulator application. If you select web application, it will check the connection explorer and it will check which is the active emulator or a device, then it will launch the application onto the targeted system. If you use this simulator option, then your application will be opened in a Chrome-based simulator. There you can debug your application. And localizing widgets. To localize widgets, currently Tizen doesn't support all the languages. It has some minimal set of languages support. In localization, you can view all the languages supported by Tizen framework. Here, for localizing your applications, there are three types of localizations. One is folder-based localization, content-based localization, and element-based localization. Is it audible? Okay. Folder-based localization means once you select this wizard to localize your application, then a unit set of files will be created for each application. On runtime, this WRT checks the current language. Based on that, corresponding HTML file will be picked. This is called folder-based localization. And element-based localization, it is an HTML standard where you can localize your application content using this language attribute. And content-based localization. Tizen framework uses globalized open source project for internalizing your applications. So you need to You need to run, you need to define your routines to, you need to L1 routines to implement this localization. Localization effects only be seen once there is a change in page reloading or your application will launches next time. It is not like a dynamic. Your application has to undergo relaunching again or reloading the page. Eclipse contents and JLint are the compiler tools which will use the compilation warnings or errors while developing. No need to build the project to know the errors. It will automatically shows while writing the application if there are any errors in your code. And log messages, console.log, you can categorize your logs either by mentioning it as info or error, warning, debug, all these things you can do using console function. Remote inspector is used to debug your application. It is not only inbuilt with simulator, even in latest SDK it has support to debug your applications on emulator also. It will launches this inspector page where you can check the variables or the call stack where it has gone through to reach that particular breakpoint. All this information you can find using this remote inspector. And after completion of your web application project, make sure that you will pass all the test cases defined by this web checker tool prior deploying your projects onto Tizen store. It has 20 test cases. All these test cases has to be passed, then only it is accepted on your Tizen store. Okay, it will generate HTML based results, and even it contains full information what is the error and how to pass that test case. And design principles. To have a common look and feel across all applications, Tizen has provided few developer guidelines. Those information is available in developer.tizen.org. To know more information about latest releases and events, you can go through all these websites. One is tizen.org, developer.tizen.org. It also provides documentation for various number of web projects and native projects, and even there is a forum support where you can contact for your queries. And source.tizen.org is a website where you can pull the code of the latest Tizen releases. Bugs.tizen.org is a Jira-based bug tracking tool where you can create launch your bug. Device APIs. As I already mentioned, apart from W3C standards and HTML5 features, Tizen exposes few APIs called device APIs to use the functionality of hardware resources. One such thing is application module where you will contain submodules called alarm, application control, and data control and package. Here, application control module is used to launch. For example, as already mentioned, if you want to launch another application, you have to define application.launch privilege. It's nothing but you are making usage of application APIs to launch another application. And if your application is, if you want to make your application as a service, this application control exposes few APIs so that your application can become a service to other applications existing on the device. It will also reduce the list of running application or installed application, and if you want to know the details of each and every application, it has this support. And communication framework. It provides support for Bluetooth and messaging network. Bluetooth means it provides APIs to know the list of Bluetooth supported device in the range and how to do pairing, how to transfer files like audios, videos or calendars, V cards, everything. and messaging, it supports MMS, SMS and email clients. Network barrier selection API module will allow us to read your SIM details. And NFC is near field communication. As it is an ISO standard, it helps us to transfer messages either to connected peer devices or wireless tags also. And push element, for example, if there is an update for your OS or even for your application, this push API will take care of it. And content, currently Tizen content is nothing but it lists the directories containing images, videos, all those content related files. And download, to know the download, you can control the download using this download APIs, whether to know the status of download, all these details are provided by this module. And input output, inside input output we have file system and message pool. In Tizen, not all the files and directories are accessible by web application. There are only few restricted files and each files are treated as a virtual file system. You have, there is some label for this virtual file system, like images, videos. Images means the location of this folder is opt, inside opt devices there is some images folder. You can, application can access only those files defined in this images folder. It cannot, for example, if under root, under user folder there are few images folder, images files. Application cannot access those images. It will access images only when, which are defined only in these file systems. And message port. Two web applications can communicate either with sockets or something like that. There is an API interface provided for that. It is nothing but a message port. For that, if you want to receive any information from other applications, you need to define a remote port. If you want to connect to, if you want to send some messages to other application, you need to define a local port. This message port is not only restricted to two web applications, you can also connect from one web application to native application also. And social, under social module we have support for bookmarks, calendar, call history, contact and data synchronization support also. And under system and UI interfaces we have sub modules called power, where you can, your application can access power request and it can release this also. And to know the information of what is the device orientation, what is the battery level, what is the what are all the sensors are turned on or turned off, those details you can get using system info APIs. And web setting is used to delete, to check the cookies or to manage your cookies. Those things you can do using web setting APIs. And finally, notification API is to create notification from your web application. Currently, there is a support for simple notification and a ticker notification. These are all the device APIs exposed by Tizen for web application developers. Any questions? Service demo can internally cannot check what all the resources your app is doing. by specifying at the beginning, security demo will come to know what are the privileges it has to restrict, what are the privileges it provides service. It's not an API level kind of thing. It is a module which will take care of the security.
But I am guessing that there could be some sort of a third-party tool that could be written that will go through your code and maybe come up with a config.xml file that will describe the privileges that the application is using, right? Now, even if it is not supported by the platform, because as you say, it can't look through the code, only use it during execution. Right? I mean, there could be a third-party tool that goes through the code and passes the code and figures out what privileges are being used. Tyson, there are three levels of privileges. One is public privilege, the other is partner privilege, and the third one is platform privilege. Public privilege is open for all the developers. They can use whatever the APIs, public APIs. They can mention that in manifest.config.xml and start using it. The partner specific privilege is given only for developers who are considered to be partners from on the Python store. So that's the reason there are different levels of privileges that needs to be mentioned in the manifesto config file. Then if those privileges are not properly mentioned, then Python platform will not allow you to run the application. So that's the reason why we have the privileges. You exercise those privileges by invoking certain APIs, right? Like for example, if you are looking at, say, the device web camera, for example, you need to go through some API, right? And you would have to declare it in your XML as well, that I want access to the camera, for example. It almost seems like I'm doing it twice. Once in my code, I'm saying I need access to the camera, and second time in the config file where I'm saying I need access, I'm using access to the web camera.
Okay.
My other question was, so if I already have a web application, how easy or difficult is it to like port it to Tizen?
Next session is by Ravi. He's going to talk about some overview of the Tizen native API.